Parliament. And Kamal Hassan, do feel free to add to this if required.
See, okay, Bulandshahr is one thing. Can I take it down south? Can I?
Down, oh yeah, you can take it in any direction.
I'll take it to Thoothukudi. The Sterlite shooting.
Okay.
The central minister says that if you can't contain it with your police, we'll send the army.
Thoothukudi.
To Thoothukudi.
Okay.
There are no cows involved, the people involved. Total apathy there. I'm bringing it to my state. The argument to my state.
What is your question to Smriti?
No, you're talking about law and order. It's about people, policemen.
Can I ask you one question on this? Ask yourself today.
Yes.
Ask yourself today very honestly, without any doubt in your mind, what caused Thoothukudi?
What
caused it? How many NGOs were out there actively, directly, indirectly, voluntarily, involuntarily inciting on the ground? Ask yourself, are there no external forces which push these flames? And since you mentioned Thoothukudi, I will also go down south, Mr. Kamal Hassan, and ask you a direct question. Why Thoothukudi, sir, since we are speaking openly today? Kudankulam.
Yeah.
Kudankulam. We know the protests which happened. Ask yourself today, when big global corporates come into the picture for nuclear reactors, do NGOs and third-party foreign UK-based talk shops, organizations which are funded from God knows where, come and incite the flames directly? Let me tell you one thing. We did a sting operation on an individual when we started the program. I'm not taking the name of that individual. An individual who won a sting operation was willing to take foreign money via a third party NGO in the name of a political party to route it to an NGO, because under the FCRA rules, funding for the NGO by their government has been stopped. So I'm asking you, sir, is everything that is happening organic, or is it being provoked separately? And why don't you take a position against those organizations, these NGOs, which fan the flames from outside? I want a response from Kamal Hassan and then a response from Smriti Irani on this specific point. Kamal Hassan first.
What do you call external forces?
Foreign forces who have no interest in the sovereignty of my country and play a third party role for global business interests. But couch themselves as activists, you know, which they are not.
I know activists who are actually activists, and
I'm asking you my question. I want a response right here, right now, on Kudankulam as a response to Thoothukudi.
Kudankulam is not what I was talking about. Yes, we will talk about that also, but there will be a position, and you'll have to have a dialogue there also, and talk to them.
Talk to whom?
Talk to whoever is opposing it.
We can't talk to foreign NGOs. We can't talk to people who don't declare their income. We can't talk to people who don't tell us where the dollars are coming from.
So talk to me. I'll tell you.
In fact, they will take a position that you are the murderer of democracy if you say, explain to me the source of the fund. Those voices get louder that here you are being oppressive because you're seeking this kind of transparency in funding.
You're trying to make it sound like Thoothukudi is a sort of outsourced attack on India. No.
Not Thoothukudi, not the people. But there are always other people instigating.
There will be people always trying to do that from outside. That's besides the point.
We protested the violence in Thoothukudi more than any other channel, and on this platform I will do. Violence against the people is abhorrent and must be confronted.
That's all I'm talking about.
But are there groups and organizations who feed people out there to violence, who simply provoke people and put up there? You see, none of these NGOs actually go up there and face the bullets.
Those NGOs did not provoke me. I went there. I pay my taxes. So if you're talking about you're not able to find out the source of that money, I have clear sources of where my money comes from.
You're speaking for yourself.
Yes. And there are many more of us who went there. I would have been there. I missed being there on that day. I don't want to face bullets, not personally me or any of my friends. But I missed being there. I would have been right in the middle of that crowd.
You know, the fundamental question, Arnab, if you allow, that we need to ask is why invest so much in disrupting growth in India? That is because there are people who know the possibility of an India which unleashes itself economically and grows exponentially. And when you say that these particular institutions that are seeking foreign funding to just be a part of the disruption, let's be also aware of the fact that it's not only a commercial establishment that they seek to destabilize. They actually also come after our communities, our children. I've had the, I don't even know the nomenclature to put it. I myself, and I've spoken in Parliament about it, seen a particular curriculum designed for certain madarsas where the basics of that curriculum was how Indian children can differ between Hindus and Muslims. And these books were designed by an NGO for those madarsas so that they could sow the seed of disharmony. So this is not as harmless as just instigating a protest. This is going beyond that. This is trying to go into certain classrooms and say that, you know, there's always been a sense of disunity, disharmony in our country, and festering violence against not only communities, but also against the Indian state. So it is, do not think it is only contained to a few protests. It actually is much more severe.
So you are trying to say that Thoothukudi was... It starts from madarsas?
Sir, I'm talking about my experience as a minister having witnessed this particular aspect of NGO activism.
I'm talking about Thoothukudi.
Yeah. Of NGO activism. And the point I'm making is that these kind of forces are not limiting themselves to only protests. They are not limiting themselves to the urban Naxal discourse. This is much worse. And as you have rightfully said, sir, and I may take you for your word, that as Indians, we need to prioritize that at what cost do I want political victory?
No,
not at the cost of the integrity and sovereignty of the country.
You want to. You respond. Go on.
I think we've digressed and we've gone genric on a question I asked about Thoothukudi, about shooting at people.
Yeah.
And we are for big industries coming into Tamil Nadu, but not under the cost of people, planet. Profit is also very important.
Yeah.
But all the three P's are important. And the priority is the planet, the people, and then the profit.
So we
do agree. And now you suddenly took it to madarsas.
I
want to know about Thoothukudi. Please come back to Thoothukudi.
In terms of priorities that you've listed, sir, I think that we put people first. And there has to be...
No, that's not what happened in Thoothukudi.
As Arnab has said, and may I join cause with him, which is very rare, that when it comes to violence against our own citizens, that is something that will not find support in, forget polity, amongst any Indian or any community.
Let me explain.
But to feel that a protest against the growth of India cannot be generated or has not been generated, sir, is to live in the darkness of all forms of communication that are clearly telling us that this is what has been happening.
All rules have been flouted in Thoothukudi. The factory should have been 25 kilometers away from the Gulf of Mannar.
I get
14 kilometers.
I get your point. I think we'll I don't want to get intricate only on this subject. Our only point here made is shooting as people is abhorrent. Instigating people is worse. I don't think she said that the problem was created in madrasas. Let me move on to a broader point. You said if the DMK Congress Alliance breaks